since I don't talk to him since 2013 because we never fight, because he made a political agreement on prosecutor's side. I don't want to mention it. I just want you to be prepared for such calls. Any of you can be. You know what's the difference? I'm an ordinary person who remained an ordinary person, a normal person, even in politics. Because many people change when they join politics. I didn't. That's the only difference between me and the others. It was a big difference. Okay, now I had a big, I have to say how many of us. We had I had in my yard as a Minister of Justice 5 red flags. Red flags means very serious concern by the commissions. If you don't solve them with some deadlines, you don't join. So I had the fight against political corruption. Like Romanians were saying, we have corruption but no corrupt. So fight against political corruption was a red flag. If I didn't solve this, we wouldn't join. Then reform of the judiciary, fight against fraud, fight against money laundering, and copyright. So I took a great responsibility on me. And it was for the country. Who asked me? One of you asked me. I think you asked me, don't send messages. Put it in the bag, please. She asked me, why did you do it? Well, what was your personal reason? That's how you asked?
Mm-hmm.
Look, I'm astonished by this question. I don't need a personal reason more than having your country into the EU. I don't think it could be something more at that time. To bring a country, to be the main actor, basically, yes? 5 red flags. To be the main actor, to bring your country into the European Union. Do I need a personal reason? It's enough, this answer?
My question was a little bit different. I was wondering, I understand that your job was very difficult. You are a woman. Every day, a lot of people were put into the jail, into the prison. And what was your personal motivator to be in a constant struggle?
That's why I started to have big dreams, big actions. Don't take risks, don't be afraid. Never to fail. Go.
Come on,
and I also have fun. I'll tell you some stories, real stories. So, I make an action plan. First of all, I saw here, I had some papers. You have a lot of strategies. They should be thrown away. You have to have one strategy, less than 10 pages. What do you want? You want an anti-corruption office? You want public declaration of assets, you have confiscation because you have a problem with confiscation, extended confiscation, and confiscation, no matter on which name it is, if it's under my control, it doesn't matter if it's my wife, my son, my husband. Okay? It's a European directive. I was rapporteur, I make it together with the council and the commission. It's like this. Many other things. So you make you want to clean the judiciary. How? You make a random distribution of cases. Then you make the electronic files. Then you make different things. You want to unify the jurisprudence. You want to have guidelines for punishments because people don't trust the judicial system for a theft. In the same conditions, one person steals, I don't know, 200 euros, one get 3 years and another 7 years, yes? That's a lottery. It depends on which country you go. So, like in UK or US, they have guidelines for punishments. For, you know, when this happens like this, you can give between this and this. So, So there are not such big differences. And unification of jurisprudence, like we have the European Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg, they work based on jurisprudence. They always refer to their own cases. As I said in the case, we said in the case of, yes, they developed case law. And also, it's predictable for people. Without a predictable justice system, no one would have trust in the judiciary. And think, even an investor or someone who does a commercial contract, you want to know, as a foreign investor, let's say, that if this clause of the contract is broken by the other party, is not respected, which is a predictable jurisprudence court decision? But you can't. So predictability in law, and don't change often the law, and have a law predictable, have the decisions predictable, bring investors, bring jobs, bring trust of the people in the judiciary. It's very important. I have problems with the judges. Judges said, we are independent at the beginning, they said. I don't care about what other judge does in a similar case, because I'm independent and I do whatever I want. So I explained and explained and explained, and maybe you also have to explain here. Independence of judiciary is a formula we are all used to. Do you know what it means?
We do not depend from the other authorities. But I think that...
I didn't say anything wrong. You are on the good road.
Independence from politicians, from other branches of authority, but I think that law is a system, and the judges cannot say that I'm independent and I don't care what other judges said, because it goes in a contradiction to that law should be predictable.
For them, predictability at the beginning, it didn't matter in 2005. We didn't understand this. And we had it's very difficult to do the reforms in the conditions that it appointed for life in the Constitution. Yes? And having judicial counsel. You have here a prosecutorial and justice counsel. Ours is one with two sections, which was already in place, and most of the powers were there, not in the minister. And they are appointed for life, once again. And only the council, the judicial council, could sanction them. The independence of the judiciary is not the right of the judge to do whatever he or she wants. However, they said, but to interpret differently the law. No, you have to do the same interpretation of the law. And people don't trust you, any of you. No one knows who is right. And that's not the point, who is right. The point is that there are different decisions on the same provision. The independence of judiciary is people's right to an independent judiciary. It's our right to have judges who are independent of the government, of the politicians, and of corruption. And professionals, because if you are not professional, you cannot be independent. If you are professional, you feel strong. You feel strong, you are sure that what you do is good. And you resist, it helps you resist any pressure. Okay? Independence of the judiciary is the right of the people to an independent judiciary. So you said, first half, perfect. I became a minister and I had these problems with so the first one is a fight against political corruption, and I had until March through the action plan. I did the action plan and I put everything I wanted to do. All the laws, so law on bankruptcy, on companies, political parties, campaigns, everything I wanted to change or I wanted to adopt, and to set up a center corruption prosecutor office and to have declaration of assets and interest public. And then to have an agency, which is called National Integrity Agency, it's called and they checked incompatibilities, conflict of interest, which I made them cry, and the declarations of assets and interest, because if you do them and they are public, it's not enough. They need to be checked against reality. Maybe you have much more than you put there, yes? And they are very, very complex, and they are very long. They have about 20 pages with the income and the spending of you and your family. I adopted in February 2005, so it was my second month of being a minister. 2 months later, I built a family. I took everything. So price is very important. What else? I did this treasury board in other countries, so I knew what's most important, so I knew how to start. Okay, we had an anti-corruption prosecutor office before I came. It was called PNA, and they had an overall competence on corruption, which is very bad. You don't make a specialized unit to have an overall competence for 10 euros or 10, I don't know, 5 euros corruption. The first case I remember was a train conductor who took a bribe from someone who didn't have a ticket. No, this is not for a specialized unit. So I changed the law and I changed the institution. And basically, and what is different from NABU, we have only one institution. I look how many agencies of anti-corruption we have. Too many. But many agencies is failure. So we have this anti-corruption director with a specific jurisdiction. High level corruption is given by two things. The position of the person, if you are prime minister, minister, deputy, mayor, judge, prosecutor, high-level police officer, high-level custom officer, the position, then it doesn't matter the amount. Or if the amount is very large and you are not in a public position. And here we have the cases, famous cases of presidents or how do you call them, footballer clubs, for which Italy and Spain and all the media there were very had envy on us. How can you make it? Because we all know that we transfer football players, there are huge amounts of money and taxes are not paid. And they were called for tax evasion, and one president of the of his club and one of the famous football player in Romania, the football player is still in prison, the other one served his term. He got, I think, 6 or 7 years, the president of the club. And he is out. But he has more cases. So we also have corruption in the system, etc. So that's how I made the companies. Plus, I said other forms of corruption over 10,000 euros, equivalent in the local currency, or crimes assimilated to corruption. And I can give you an example. If you have political influence, like you are the head of the party, and you use the political influence to get an advantage for you or for someone else. And that happened to the former prime minister as a president of the party, although he was a prime minister, but he campaigned for the presidential elections. And he made a competition with some industries, out of this, you follow the money, and then you see that from this so-called competition of some industries, all the money went into t-shirt with his name and electoral material for the campaign for the candidate of presidency. It's very important to follow where the money comes from, where they go. That's how you discover crime. So that was the first case of someone convicted for violating the law on political funding of political campaign. So I, okay, I keep making breaks. I found myself in this prosecutor's office, which was, which has no such jurisdiction as I made, was doing nothing basically. Train conductors is nothing. And I knew I wanted to change. I changed the law of appointment and so on after I consulted the commission and I got their opinion. I believe in individual responsibility, not in collective responsibility. It was a collective nomination. No one is responsible if things go wrong. So I changed the law like this. The Minister of Justice proposes, has interviews as a competition and proposes a candidate. The candidate is found by the Judicial Council, is public, or it is there for the candidate answer the questions. And then it goes to the president, who can say, yes, it's appointed. He said, no, he has to argue why no, indeed. Yes? So, what I did? I acted quickly. I had to finish the leadership of the previous one, yes, in order to build the second one. So I decided to do it again. Like this. So in 1 second, I made a short press conference, press statement, and I sent all the leadership, all the five, the head, the two deputies, the head of departments of these institutions are revoked, are proposed to be revoked. And then they went to the council and the president revoked them. All of a sudden, decapitated, as they said. Macovei decapitated the institution. Yes, I did. And then I appointed someone from the General Prosecutor Office, so not from them, as interim. And then I went for others. I changed the law, as I told you, and then for others. I didn't know prosecutor, I was also spending time abroad. I made a public announcement in the newspapers, I asked around about good people. Anyway, we had an interview with 8 or 9 prosecutors from the head of DNA. And I had a psycholog, you say, with also psychology Romanian, a psychologist with me. It was so useful. I used him for any competition I made, including for the actors of presidentialists or head of general congress or anything. Because they read the body language and they measure the integrity, the honesty, they measure the resistance to political pressure, the, how they work and how they get under pressure or under emotion. And the psychologists ask questions to all candidates and then and everyone who are more asking questions. And each of us had an evaluation, then I stayed along with the psychologist who made for each candidate. He took each candidate for all these criteria. And he said, that guy lied to you at that question. You know, you look into the eyes of the person when you answer a question, you feel accommodating, you take some time to think what to answer, you give an evasive answer, you get reddish. For instance, I remember one guy was asked, do you like women? He got red. We had like 10 people around the table. And he said yes. He was married. And he said yes. But the psychologist knew that. And he wanted to see if he tells the truth or not in front of 10 unknown people. He got red. And he said, yes, I like women. Just an example. And then give them situation, how would you react if this happens? But you have to answer very quickly. In the interviews, they also do this mathematical testing for the European Commission, if you want to be employed. That you do, you have on computer, like 5 seconds to give some answer or to make some yes, or 10 seconds, and then they move, you can't go back or you can't change. Okay, and finally he said, this guy, and that was the one I proposed, Ariel Morar, this guy is, and I quote, he's like a stone, no one is going to change his opinion, even if even you will not change his opinion if you'll be the person to propose him as chief prosecutor. He's not a charming person, and he's not socializing. He's not the type to socialize. And I said, that's the perfect person I want. A guy who is like a stone, who doesn't listen to anyone. I'm not going to tell him what to do. And this is what this country needs. And if you want to do real political fight against real corruption, to socialize, chief prosecutor to socialize, forget it. Take another job. You have to socialize with whoever. You go to with oligarchs or you go with politicians, as it happened. And of course they were filmed. But even if you go with friends out, yes, you don't know what happened to your friend. And it comes before you. I remember one case, he was on TV, and he was asked, he was still a chief prosecutor, now we have Laura Crăveși, whom I also interviewed for general prosecutor office, and she was. He was asked, because they arrested a judge, who was a close friend, a family friend of him. He was not from Bucharest. They were from the same, from Cluj, from the same city, and they were friends. And their kids were playing together. And the journalist is asking him during the interview, how could you investigate and arrest you know, your best friend with whom your children is playing? Did you think of his, the future of his children? And he looked at the journalist and he said, me? I should think at the future of his children. He should have thought of the future of his children and not their pride. So, no mother, no father. Yes, that's a guy. It also said something very important. He said only very good people make a difference, not good people. It's not enough to be a good person. I need to be good professional and so on. You have to be very good. And then other people like him came, interviews and so on, so we built it. Now with the judges. With the judges it was more difficult. I had no competence and I didn't want to have. It was the Judicial Council proposing judges on the Supreme Court. The judges, it took like about 2 years. So we had the first cases with politicians already in 2005 and 6. And the judges initially gave suspended sanctions for serious crimes. I remember a case when a state company for forest, they bought this costume when you go down the water.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Well, or for the tie, what you use, what's the tie here? But you know, with diamonds, and with a lot of money, or and a tank. Come on. Why? Because you have friends who need to make money and who need to sell this. And that was acquitted. I don't know why. I don't know why. I think the judges were afraid at that point. It was the first time when this happened in Romania. So the first were the prosecutors who got all the equipment they needed from the Americans, from the EU countries, who got a lot of training, yes. And they were the first to be powerful. And once you do, you question two politicians, I think that's enough. You go on, you know, it's even fun. Then judges started to give suspended sanctions, and then they started to give real sanction. Prison, 6 years, 10 years. We have a judge, 21 years in prison. We have an oligarch and a senator at the same time owning the TVs, the radios, and the former Secretary General and a senator, he got 10 years in prison, for instance. Now, I said about real stories, so I set up this institution. It's different from yours, I will just say this, because everything is embedded in one. The prosecutor is there, the judicial police or the detective investigators, as you call them, are there under the leadership of the chief prosecutor, financial specialist, IT specialist, all specialists you want in the world, and they have terminals for wiretaping, and they have all the equipment to put microphones, to do filming, to do specific surveillance. So, why it's important? They are all together under one person, one leadership, and they work with the case prosecutor. They will have independence for the case from the prosecutors. If your chief prosecutor comes and asks what you do in your case, you can say, it's not your business. But if you need advice and you go to the chief prosecutor, you need to consult, yes, it's fine. But if you are asked to give information, no. It's your case, it's your responsibility. You can say no. Nothing can happen to you. It's in the law. So that's how it works, why it works. And there are no leaks, that's important. You don't go to any institutional summit. If you go to an institutional site, it's almost impossible not to leak information, yes? Okay. Institution is set up, people are appointed, not all of them, but enough to start working. And the first case comes, first information comes in the media. At the end of 2005, I was in the government, that the vice prime minister of that government was summoned to DNA, was called to DNA to be questioned. After 2 days, we have government session. Everyone is looking, all my colleagues were looking at me very differently. With fear, also with hate, also with, and one said, we have the minister we have the minister of justice in government and we are investigating. Yes. And here again, think, what could happen? They would fire me. So what? I have a job. It's very good you have a job. You don't depend on a party. It's not the party who gives you the job. You are a good professional. You do your job. I said, yes, okay, Prime Minister starts. And that's real. He said, Monica, I thought we go after the opposition. To me, it was really funny. I mean, I also had fun, believe me. That's the rest of the rocky road. It was a rocky road, but if you are strong, if you have an objective, and you look at these people, and you know you don't give up, you know you never give up, whatever happens, then it's easy. And it was one person who wanted me, then one chief prosecutor, yes? So that's why I say one person can make a change. I'm coming back. I thought we got the opposition. I said, that's wrong. I didn't join this team to do this. And first, you don't go after anyone. It's based on evidence. It could be 5 times in a row someone from a party, then someone from another party, power or opposition. In years, it will be a balance. Because you know you have a cross party crisis. Yes, but all these cases done by the socialists and he enumerated cases which are in the media, it's true. I said, fine. If the prosecutors would find evidence for them, they will do them. Now, they found evidence for Mr. Kopos, who was faced, you know, cross like you, yes, member of the government, but he was vice prime minister. It was prime minister, 2 vice prime ministers. He was shouting at me over the table, I will never talk to you again. Fine. So, thank you. Yes. take this memo, and take it to the prosecutor. I said, no, you take it to the prosecutor.